dear children, so here I am back for the explanation of letter writing. Now in my previous video I was explaining about the formal letter writing, right? I had given you the format, I had explained you, so once again let me recollect that what we had studied that, right? So now the format of formal writing, okay? Format of the formal letter writing. So here first is sender's address, which should be in three lines or two lines you can write. Then you have to leave a line, write the date, then again leave a line, then receiver's address. Then leave a line, you have got salutation or you can say your greeting, right? Then you leave a line and write the subject, which is very important in the formal letter writing. Subject, which is very important. So here the subject should be short, to the point, what exactly you want, you have written in the letter, okay? Then after that, since I have got no space, so I have to rub it. And then after that, you have the body of the letter. Body should be at least 2 to 3 paragraphs. You can have more paragraphs. Okay. Then after finishing writing the body of the letter, you have to again leave a line. Then you have the complimentary close. Then you write your name. Now when you write your name at the end in the formal letter writing, remember you should write your surname also, okay? But when you are writing the informal letter, that is your friendly letter to your parents, brother, sister, cousins, relatives, so that time you need not write your surname. But in the formal letter you have to write your surname. So here I'm specifying name with surname. Okay, so now this is the total format of your formal letter writing. Okay, so now first we have the sender's address, so that means the person who is writing the letter. Then we have date. The format of date should be this way: 21st June 2021, in this format. Then again you leave a line, you have the receiver's address, that means who is going to receive the letter or to whom you are writing the letter. Then again you leave a line, then salutation, that is respected sir or madam, dear sir or madam, respected principal, so that is your salutation. Then again you leave a line, then you write the subject. Here the word subject should be written, and along with that then you have to write this, the in short phrase you have to write that what exactly you are conveying in the letter. Then after that you, without leaving a line, you write the body of the letter, which consists of 3 paragraphs. Then after finishing your letter you leave a line, you have your complimentary close, that is before this you have to finish thanking you, okay? After this, yours truly, in complimentary close, yours truly, yours faithfully, yours sincerely, yours obediently. So here that you will be writing, and then here your name with surname. Remember, this is the format of your formal letter writing, okay? Now I'll explain you, or I'll give you the format of the informal letter writing. Okay. persona here in the informal letter writing. That means you are writing the letter to your friend, cousins, relatives, parents, anyone. Okay? So, informal letter. So, again here, sender's address. Then again leave a line, then write date, again leave a line, receiver's address, then you leave a line, you have salutation or your greetings. Okay, then you have your body. Without leaving a line, you have your body. Body again should be of 2 to 3 paragraphs. It can be of 4 paragraphs also. Then after that, you have your, after finishing your body, you leave a line. Then you have your complimentary clause. And your name. You should not write your surname. Remember, this is your informal letter. Your parents, relatives, everybody, friends know your surname. So you need not write the surname. So again, once again, we will go through. First is the sender's address. That means your address, since you are writing the letter. After that, you leave a line. Date. Date again should be in that format which I have showed for formal letter writing. Then you have your receiver's, leave a line, receiver's address, then again leave a line, salutation. So here it is totally dear. Okay. No need to write respected. Even if you are writing to your grandparents, uncle, aunt, your parents, no need to write respected because they are your family members. So they are very dear to you. You can write dear. And then dear papa, dear grandfather, dear, you write your friend's name, okay? Remember, after this, there is no comma also. This comma also should not be there, okay? Then, without leaving a line, you have your body. After you finish the body, which can maybe of 3 to 4 paragraphs, you leave a line. Then you have your complimentary clause. In complimentary clause, your loving, your loving grandson, your loving granddaughter, yours loving friend, okay, yours affectionately. So you can use such type of complimentary clause. Then you write your name and do not write your surname. If you write your surname, your marks will be reduced, okay. So these are the two formats of your two types of letters. So I hope that you have understood. Please watch it carefully. Note down the steps that I have explained. Okay. So thank you and have a wonderful day.